in fourth place with Alexander Gagsi, and then Victoria Sinitsina and Ruslan Zhiganjin. Kathy and Chris Reed, another brother and sister, they dropped to ninth. And all of these, I'm afraid, won't qualify. 20 make it through to the free dance, which you can see here tomorrow. So we're going to take a break, and when you come back, it'll be the final group of five, including the Brits. On the ice, it's their chance to shine. Runners-up in American Championships, and they've always been second best to the Olympic champions Merrill Davis and Charlie White. But here's their chance here, with the main contenders so far not doing themselves justice. They were eighth in the Olympics. What here for Madison Chock and Evan Bates.
There's no business like show
out of their fin step. They look good to me. First section completed now. They're looking sharp. Yeah, that was good. They do look really, really sharp. That was a super bit of footwork.
Well, they've come on a bundle in the last couple of years. It's only 3 years since they started. But last year moved up to seventh in the world, and it could be better than that this year. Could be knocking on the door of a podium place, because it has looked a little inviting now for the other couples. Disappointing in the Olympics, only eighth place for them, but really on form here in the short dance in Saitama.
Yeah, as far as I could tell, they didn't put a foot wrong throughout that. The fin step looked very, very good indeed. Really tidy footwork. The judges looking to make sure that the skaters are on the correct edges at all times. It's difficult to tell at full speed, but from what I could see, there didn't look to be any of the key points missed there. Twizzles look good, sorry.
Go for it.
Yeah, no, the twizzles look really, really good. I'm pretty sure they're going to get their levels on that, and the GOEs should be good.
Busy time for Igor Spielband, as always. And he's got Capellini and Lanotti still to go.
Wonderful expression. Great choice of music for these two. Another team that really do suit this rhythm. Great close-up shots. Just show you how close they are together. Of course, the closer they are, the more dangerous it gets, and the more difficult it is. So let's take a look at those twizzles. A little bit out of sync on that first set. There's pretty much no doubt they're going to get the levels, but will they get the thumbs up from the judges? Look much better there. Holding the skate gets the level up. Of course, it's much more difficult. This is a great focus point right towards the judging panel, which takes up the whole length of the rink here. Lovely deep knee bend.
And looks like they had fun too.
They made it look easy. But there was some intricate footwork going on there in that mid-light step sequence, no doubt about that. The rotational lift right at the end. Should get level four for that, and don't think it went over the limit of 6 seconds. Beautiful.
Remember, it's the French couple in first place at the moment, 68-20. They're not far away. 67-71 for these two. So within half a mark, that will all be decided tomorrow. 67.71. Their season best score bringing them currently in second place. Even though Tessa Virtue and Scott Moyer have retired or left the competitive ranks, Canadians still very much in the ascendancy at the moment. Two in the final group here. A couple who didn't make it to Olympics but were 18th in the world's last year in Canada.